Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is the world away and happy Thursday. Today we're going to be doing pack 8 of the Agora Models release. I built the Jaguar E-Type. Now in pack 8 we're all going to be doing the interior of the vehicle, but I don't know if you remember last time when we saw this pack, we finished off the third rim, which looked like that. That was a pain to do. So we're going to be starting these stages by putting the tire on that. And then, as I said, we're going to be working on the interior. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down in the video description for Agora Models. You can get this all the way from pack one. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So I've already got my dirty old tea towel up here. And what I'm going to do is I've already put, as you can see, tire in boiling water in there. It's been sitting there for a couple of minutes already. I'm going to fish this out and put this into the rim that we created earlier, and just checking that looks good. And there we go, that's the third tire completed. So I'm going to be bringing over the back of the chassis that we've worked on previously, and we're going to be putting this into place. So we're going to be putting this one in here. We've got the hub carrier here. We want to make sure that this section here is engaged into that. You want to make sure before you put the wheel on that obviously the hub has actually gone all the way through here, so it's sitting up like that. Put the wheel on top, just make sure that these two little prongs at the bottom there match the two holes in there, just like that. We put a washer in, which I've already got in there, and then a M07 screw just in here. And then get that nice and tight on there. That's in all the way, no wobble. And as you can see, still able to turn, no problems at all. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Then stage 58, as you can see, we're starting the interior now. And this is the interior floor pan. Did you see I said it right this time? I'm always calling this thing a floor plan. Floor pan. Got a floor pan here. We've also got a switch. And quite simply, the switch is just going to go into the hole at the side. So we're going to feed this through all the way here. And put the switch inside the hole. It's going to be tight fit, but we want to press it all the way in here. Matter of fact, I'm just going to use a screwdriver just to help me push that down. As you can see, the resistance of that is actually going to hold that in. But what they also want us to do is just push these metal tabs over to stop it coming back out again. So I've got my pliers here. I'm going to take that end tab and bend it over. Matter of fact, it's probably easier to do it with my flat nose tweezers here. Same job. That's one. And two. There we go. That switch isn't coming out. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 59, we're going to be working on the transmission tunnel, which I used to sit on as a kid, back in the days when you can fit 15 people in a car. And we're going to be taking the right speaker mount looking like that. We have got a bezel to go around, which is just going to go into the hole here. Push that in. That's flush all the way. That looks like that. Once we've got that, we're going to be putting a speaker grill just inside the speaker there. These are pretty impressive. Let me get one up to show you what that looks like. Check that out. Little metal grill there. Gonna drop that in there. Not like that. We're gonna drop it just around the lip in there. There you go. And then we're gonna be attaching what we've just created there on top. Pushing that in. It's got three lugs to hold this in. Make sure it's secure all the way around. There we go. Looks good. Got a speaker. Do exactly the same on the other side. And there you go. That's both sides in, looking just like that. Put that to one side because we're going to be working on the radio now. This is what the radio looks like. Pretty cool. And we're going to be putting the back fascia just over this section like this, through the hole, so it looks like that from the front there. That's going to go into the slot that we can see just there, this way around. We want it to face us, so it's going to sit in like that, but it is going to be held in from the back with an AG05 screw. Now this is a flange screw, as you can see there. It's just going to be screwed in here. And that is all there is to do in that stage. In stage 60, we're going to do some of the driver controls, which does include the gear stick, as you'll see drop out there. So I'm going to grab the gear stick, looking like that, and I'm going to be suppressing it into this mount here that looks like that. Now when we put this in, it has got a keyhole pattern. It's going to go in like that. We want to make sure that the tabs are sitting down there. And then this whole section is going to be attached to this center plate. Again, matching up that keyhole pattern. So this is going to go in just like that there. Look at the detail on that. We're going to hold that in from the other side just with AG06 screw. Got that here. And just put it through the hole at the bottom there. Nice and tight. That looks brilliant. I like that. Okay, put that to one side because now we have got the pedals, the gas, accelerator and clutch. Bring over the car here. Now obviously this is an English car, so it's the right way round. That's going to upset the Americans. This is just going to go over the top here just like that on those two pins there. Now to keep that in, once again, we've got an AG06 screw just going down the center. I didn't mean that to my American friends. You all drive on the wrong side of the road, we know that. There you go. Okay, so once the pedals are in, I haven't got to do anything with that. Put that to one side. We're going to take that center console now and we're going to be attaching the gear stick to it. So as you can see, we have got the locating lug here. This is just going to go on like that. I need some AG04 screws because that's what's going to keep this in place. We're actually putting three AG04 screws in to keep this in place. So one at the top here. And then two just here and here. We've then got the handbrake to put in. As you can see, the handbrake has got two little pins at the bottom. They're going to match the pins that we've got there. That's going to sit in like that. Turn it over, and once again, we've got a tiny screw to put in there now. That's one of these silver AG01 screws. Don't put this in too tight. Just tight enough to hold that in. And there we go, that's the handbrake in as well. We're going to actually put this whole section now into the floor pan, matching where it actually goes on here. So this is just going to go in here like this. Perfect. Turn it upside down, and we're going to be putting some AG06 screws to hold this in. Probably best on the top camera, just one in this section at the back there, and then just one more into this point just at the side here, and that's it. That is all there is to do at stage. Okay, in stage 61, we're going to be creating the foam back seats here. Let's just get these out. We have already created some seats previously, but what we're going to be doing is we're going to be taking this part of the seat, this sort of grill section here, and we're going to be putting the shaped foam inside just like that. Then we're going to be matching that off with the top side here, making sure this goes all the way around. Get this. There you go. So it's fitting nice and flush around there. Perfect. We could just leave that to one side now. I do like the cushion material in there. And once again, we have got a switch to put in. So I'm just going to open the screws because this is going to get a little bit fiddly. And I'm going to be putting the first switch just into this section here. Now, as you can see, the switch has a gap between the wires. That gap is going to fit over that plastic section just there. So once it's in, it in just like that. So bringing over the car again, I need to actually get this into place, it's going to go into this hole just at the back there. So I need to hold it with my hand so it doesn't fall out. Put the switch through the hole. And I'm going to hold this in with those flanged AG05 screws. And one in that side. And then we can check that when we press the brake pedal, you should hear the click of the switch. And with this and the seat, that's all there is to do in that stage. In issue 62, we're going to start installing the seats. So I've got these ones here. As I said, we have already made one of these. So what we're going to do, we've got these two lugs at the bottom. We're just going to push them down into the lugs on the seat. So it's nice and flush on the end there. We're going to be taking this cushion that we had before, and that's going to go in here. And once again, we have got lugs at the bottom to line this up to get this all in. So probably best to put the front in first and then push that into place, making sure we've got it around the right way. Perfect. There we go. That's the seat in. Make sure your lugs are through. That looks excellent there. And then this is just going to go into the passenger side, just over this side here, just like that. And it's going to be held in with screws from the other side, and they are AG06 screws. You want to be careful when you turn this over because you don't want to break that gear stick there. Here's number two. And there we go. That's that seat in perfectly. Now we need to take the seat that we assembled in stage, I think it was 15. And as you can see, that looks just like this. That's just going to be the driver's seat. It's going to go in that side. And that's screwed in exactly the same way. And that is all there is to do in that stage. That interior looks lovely. Now, stage 63 is the start of the dashboard. We don't actually do anything in this stage. We just actually get the surround here. But believe me, we're going to make up for that in the next stage. And as I said, we're going to make up for it. This is the final stage here. Check out everything in there. We have got absolutely loads to do as we make the steering column. So here we go. The first thing we're going to need are these little chrome parts here. I'm just going to drop them down on the close-up camera so you can see them. Okay, so quite simply, we're going to be putting these into the two holes that we can see each side. So the one with two, the heater control, is going to go on the other side over here. And that just goes in like that. And the one with one switch goes nearest to the dashboard there. The dashboard instrument panel there. Perfect. Now we've got a sticker to put on, which is the instrument panel here. That looks just like this. I need to take the adhesive off. So you want to align this sticker up. Make sure it's the right way around and it's straight. Feed it all the way in. I'm just going to use my tweezers just to get right around the edge. Push that down. There we go. And that looks perfect in there like that. Put that to one side because we've got some more control panels to sort out. We've got the bezel there and we've got the dials. Now this is one whole sticker sheet here. So again, let's get the backing off of this and put this just on top of this section. Just here again, making sure that's perfectly straight on there. We're going to bring over the dashboard again because we've got a window to put in here that looks just like this here, and we want to have the this section here protruding out, so this is going to slot over that section just like that. We've got a switch here to put in next to it, and that's going to go into the hole that we can just see there. And the reason we've got that in now is because when we put the dashboard panels on, it's going to hold that in there. I do want to just make sure that the wires are either side of this hole here, because we don't want to be putting a screw through that hole. And at the same time, I'm going to be putting the fascia just over the top here. It's probably best to put that in first and then put the switch in, because the switch is going to want to fall out, you see, so up that side just enough to get the switch in. Perfect. Then I can push that down, make sure the switch is coming out the other side, which it is. And there we go, that's in place there. Now we're going to hold that in. So we're going to use some AG06 screws, and we're going to be putting those into the two holes here to hold the dashboard in. So one there. And just one on the other side here. And that should be enough. You can see there's the dials there looking perfect, but that should be enough to hold the switch in. And as you can see, probably hear a clicking there. That's in, no problems at all. Now you will be tempted to put a screw in there to hold that in. That gets done later on, so don't panic about that. Okay, we've got some more fascia to put on now. Told you this was a big stage, didn't I? And that's gonna look like that. We've got a plastic bezel to put, or plastic screens to put behind it. They look just like this and fit in perfectly like that there. These are gonna go onto the dials that we just created previously. So it's gonna slip in there like that. So now the dials, as you can see, are behind glass. We're gonna hold that in from this side here, just with some screws, and they are the AG04 screws. And that should be in nice and secure like that. And we're gonna use one of these small AG04 screws just to secure in where that switch is here. Just like that. And now that will keep that switch into place. See, able to click. We could put that whole thing to one side, looking really good, isn't it? I do like that. Okay, because we're going to start just working on the steering column now. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do for this is we're going to take the control stalk, and there is a pin in here that this is just going to fit on just like that there. We're then going to be taking the actual steering rod, looking like that. And we're going to be having the thicker section down the bottom here, the thinner section up here. It's actually just going to fit into the channel, getting this in like that there. So these two sections here are laid out. Hopefully you can see this on one of the cameras. I'm going to put the other side on. That's going to clamp everything into place, just like that. And hold that in with some of these AG04 screws again. So two this time. One of them is just into this little point here. Perfect. And the other one is just into the little point there. We've got two more to put in, and they are just going to go on the opposite side, just on the top of the steering column here. So one in here and one just in the other side. And then the last thing to do that we had from issue, when did we get this? I think this was stage one, actually. This is the steering wheel here. We're just going to be putting this into this section. Now, it has got a D-shaped pattern. So we're just going to push that on. And as you can see, we now have a steering wheel in place. Looks good. Now we're going to mount this. So once again, I'm going to take over the dashboard. The steering's going to go into this section here. So just line up all the holes, and this is going to go on top just like that there. That's going to be held in once again with AG04 screws. We need four this time. But once you've got a couple in, this should be quite an easy thing to put in. And there we go. That's the steering wheel in place. And that is all there is to do in that stage. And if I just bring over the interior floor pan as well, that is all there is to do in this pack. That was quite a simple pack, really. Makes a change for this week coming back. I don't know if it's me being away for 2 weeks, but I've been finding things a lot harder at the moment, but a good way to do it. So that's the Jaguar completed. I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.